Now, I know it may not look like it by the setup of my room, but I actually got into video gaming quite late in life. Probably only a few years ago. Obviously I'd played like bits and pieces on like the DS and the Wii when I was younger, but I wouldn't say it was until high school when I would consider myself into video games. And over the years, I've been working on going back and playing a lot of games that I feel like I miss out on. A lot of classics, a lot of retro games, and so I've had to build up my console gaming collection. I will always be a physical media kind of person. If I can have the actual console and the actual game in my hands, I would much rather do that than something like emulate. Yes, it's expensive, but I enjoy it. So I wanted to give a quick little tour of all of the consoles that I have, because I think I've got like 10 or 15 total. Basically, my idea with this all is if I ever find a game that I want to play, I probably have a means to play it. Let's start in the streaming room. This is my Nintendo Switch. This is the Nintendo Switch OLED, specifically the Pokemon Scarlet and Violet Special Edition. I started off with the base model Switch and that released, then I upgraded to an OLED when that released, and then I got the Special Edition one when that came out. Sticking with Nintendo, we've got a couple Wiis here. This black one is my main Wii. I actually got this for free. And this is one of the ones that are backwards compatible to GameCube games, so I can play both Wii and GameCube games using this. This one below it, I was also gifted by someone. It's modded. I haven't actually used it, but it's there. Next is the Xbox 360. Obviously, this will play 360 games and a lot of original Xbox games as well. I got this because although I do have an Xbox One that we'll get to later, a lot of the 360 games I have aren't compatible with the Xbox One, so that's what this guy's for. Next are the PlayStation boys. These are probably the coolest things I think in my collection. This is the special edition pink PlayStation 2 Slim with the matching controller. And I got this guy as a backup in case this one ever dies. This is the original model PS3. This is the backwards compatible one, so it can play PS1, 2, and 3 games. But with how old these guys are, I know they're kind of a ticking time bomb, so the day it does die and I can no longer play 1 and 2 games, that's what this guy's for. Of course, we have my laptop, but this guy is very underpowered. It's running a 1050, so I can't even play a lot of indie games without lag. It's mostly used for streaming. Next, moving to the living room, this is the Xbox One, specifically the Xbox One X. I used to have the base model Xbox One, and when that started to die, I upgraded to this. The only reason I really kind of have this one, honestly, is for Gears of War and Halo. Otherwise, I would probably get rid of it. Because like I said, a lot of the 360 games I have aren't compatible with it, but it's here. And then this is my backup PS3. This is the slim version, so it can play 1 and 3 games, but it can't play PS2 games. This one I also actually got for free. There's like consoles in every damn room, I swear. This is the PlayStation 5. Obviously, this one can play PS4 and 5 games, so I can basically play anything from the entirety of the PlayStation generations. This is just the base model. I didn't bother upgrading to the Slim because there were no hardware differences. I do also have a 1 terabyte external hard drive on it, and I also have a 2 terabyte SSD installed in it as well. But on the off chance that they ever do release a pro version, I'll probably upgrade it to that. Next, we move on to handhelds. Starting oldest, we have the Pokemon Edition Game Boy Color. It is missing the back battery compartment, but that's okay. This one obviously plays original Game Boy games and Game Boy Color games, and this one I bought off of a friend. Next is this Game Boy Advance SP. This one obviously plays Game Boy games, Game Boy Color games, and Game Boy Advance games. It's covered in Pokemon stickers because the front of it's quite scratched. This one I got for $50 off of Facebook Marketplace. Next is this DS Lite that I have. This one plays Game Boy Advance games and DS games. This one I found on the side of the road one day. It had broken hinges and scratched screens, but I recently got those repaired. I also have the baby pink DS Lite. This one I got because at the time the black one was broken and I'd always wanted the pink one. This one I bought for like 50 bucks off someone on Facebook. Next is the Nintendo DSi XL. My very first console was actually the regular Nintendo DSi. And then when the XL came out, I upgraded to this one. So this plays all DS games. The bottom screen's a tad scratched, but I do have screen protectors on them. And lastly is the Nintendo 3DS. This one I got for Christmas one year from my mum, secondhand from EB Games. It's got this black protective cover on it because the paint on the front of it is peeling off from all the use, but this guy has stuck with me for many years now. And the 3DSs, obviously, they play DS games and 3DS games. So there we go. That is all of the consoles that are in my possession. I can now basically play any game ever that I would want to. The only other console I don't have that I was considering picking up at one point was the Nintendo 64, but as it turns out, the few games on there that I actually wanted to play got added to the Nintendo Switch, so I feel like I don't need it anymore personally, and that saves me like 300 bucks. And of course, I have nothing Sega in my collection, but most Sega games did not stay Sega exclusive, so I can basically play any games just on a different console. Let me know what your guys' first ever console was and what your favorite console is as well, if it's still in your collection.